and stroll right into town and be just like the other men. I'm tired of walking around. Oh, ooby-doo, I want to be like you. I want to walk like you, talk like you. Choo-choo. You see, it's true. An ape like me can learn to be human too.
Hello everyone, and welcome to week 8 of summer reading, and our stop today is going to be in the rainforest. So I am your three-toed sloth today, and so we're going to do like we normally do. I'll start with a book, and then we will do a craft, and we'll do Miss Suzanne's activity, and then we'll finish with our snack. So our book today is called Jazzy in the Jungle. And they're playing hide and seek. Mama Jojo and baby Jazzy are playing hide and seek in the jungle. Where are you, baby Jazzy? Not here, says the anteater. Not here, says the snake. Not here, says the hummingbird. Not here, says lizard. Not here, says leopard. Try looking by the tum-tum trees. Mama Jojo looks by the tum-tum trees. Where are you, baby Jazzy? Not here, says curly whirly bird. Not here, says chameleon. Not here, says parrot. Not here, says crocodile. Not here, says hairy caterpillar. Not here, says gorilla. Try looking by the fluff-fluff flowers. There's the fluff-fluff flowers. Mama Jojo looks by the fluff-fluff flowers. Where are you, baby Jazzy? Not here, says tiger. Not here, says frog. Not here, says big red bird. Not here, says dragonfly. Not here, says baboon. Not here, says butterfly. Not here, says elephant. Let's all look by the big boo trees. Oh, baby Jazzy, will I ever find you? All right, I'm gonna step back so you can all see it. Yes, 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 all those animals, because, oops, too many pages. Found you, baby Jazzy. I love you, Mama Jojo. So many fun animals there in the rainforest, and we're gonna learn a little bit more about those animals when Miss Suzanne comes up, but first, we're gonna do our craft with Miss Rosalie. Good afternoon, everyone. So one of the things that's really interesting in the rainforest is that it can be lots of rain. And it's not like always tons and tons, like a big storm, but it can be even just a little bit of rain. And so we're making rain sticks so you can help make that rain sound. Okay, so here is my example I made, a snake. Okay, and so I've got a little corn in there. You can see it sounds a little different if you have corn or beans or rice in those tubes. All right, so in your kit, you're gonna have a large piece of paper that's an animal print. There was a bunch of different options. You have one of these tubes, which is really cool to find. It's like a little poster tube. And then we sent you home with some corn and just a kind of variety of things, you know, googly eyes and pipe cleaners and puff balls. Okay, so all kinds of different things to help make your rain stick how you would like. All right, so now to get started, the first thing is you'll want to put the corn in your tube, okay? So you're just gonna have to like loosen up the tube, pulling on both sides. And then you'll want to pour your corn in, and I suggest that you do it over another container so that you don't have corn on your floor. Okay, there we go. All right, and then don't forget to make sure that that is back in there nice and tight. All right, so next, you can use what you have. You might have other scraps and things around your house. You can think of an animal that you would like to make your rain stick look like. So I picked, I happen to have some zebra print paper, right? And so you can help measure your tube. You can use a ruler and pen, or you can just kind of eyeball it. So you're gonna kind of see how to make a straight line so that when you roll your paper, you wanna make sure you have enough to cover the whole tube. And also you wanna make sure it comes just to the end of the tube. Right, so I'm gonna finish these last cuts here. So now my paper is the size I need for my tube. And I'm going to use some tape. So it's kind of like when you wrap a present. You can put a little piece of tape on one end of the paper, roll it around the tube, and then put some more tape on the paper. A couple spots is good. And there we go. Okay. And now, you decorate however you'd like your animal to be. So I kind of just thought about a few little pieces of, what are some things on a zebra that I want to have on my rain stick? So I wanted to put some eyes. Okay, so we sent you home with these peel and stick eyes. And then I wanted to have my zebra have like a nose or snout of some sort. I'm gonna use a puffball for that. And when I'm using my puffball, I'm gonna use some craft glue. School glue works pretty well too. Probably not a glue stick as much, but don't forget you'll need to give it some time. Just a little bit of time to dry. And then when I was looking at things about what kind of animals can you find in the rainforest, I learned and remembered that a lot of plants and animals in the rainforest haven't even been discovered yet. And then the ones that have been discovered, and because we are cutting down lots of the trees in the rainforest, they become endangered, at risk, and some have even become extinct. So the rainforest is a very unique and important habitat. All right, so then, you know, I could think of different ways to do this, but just for on camera, I want my zebra to have a tail. Just kind of twist on pipe cleaners there. And then my last thing would be I want my zebra to kind of have some ears. So I'm going to use tape for my pipe cleaner to get attached. And so it's really fun, this craft, how you get to just do it really however you want. I'm sure with all the crafts we've been having this summer, you're collecting a supply of extra things, so that'll come in handy as we get to these last few weeks. All right, so there's my zebra inspired rain stick. And how fast or slow you turn it is how your rain sounds. Okay, have fun.
Hello, friends. I'm happy to see you today. Okay, so for our letters of the alphabet for this week, we have K is for kinkajou, S is for sloth, and X is for Xenops. And this is a type of bird you would find in the rainforest. I think it's a South American rainforest, this one specifically. So there are lots of different rainforests all over the world, but the main ones are in Africa and or South America. Those are the most popular ones. So what we're going to talk about today are the different types or different layers of the rainforest. So the rainforest is actually, so you have this really great information sheet, and it talks about how the rainforest is divided into four zones, okay? You have the layers, kind of like a cake. You have different layers of a cake. So the very top zone is the emergent layer. Okay, that's very, very top. You can see the sky. And so that layer is where most of the birds and insects, butterflies live up there, the very, very top. And the next layer, right underneath the emergent layer, is the canopy. Okay, so there's a layer, and so that it still gets sunlight, but there's still going to be some shadows and things like that. And that you're going to find animals like some more birds, so like maybe bigger birds like the toucans, and that's where your monkeys are going to start to hang out too. So you're going to start getting some monkeys in that layer, and more birds, and maybe even and more insects probably. And then underneath that is called the understory. Okay, so you go down a little bit farther, and that's where your snakes and your tree frogs and some of the other animals that live maybe on the lower branches of the tree. Okay, so some of those big snakes that you see, like in big snake in the Jungle Book movie, that would be where Ka lives, would be in the understory. And then we have the forest floor, and that's where like the big mammals live, like your jaguars and your elephants and your Grand Cayman alligators, and those really big mammals and reptiles, they would live in your understory. So the understory is really cool. Only 2% of light gets through all the way to the understory. So it's gonna be really dark down there. So you probably have some big creepy spiders down there too, and some other animals, like Miss Rosalie was talking about, some animals that maybe haven't even been discovered yet. They may be in the understory, or they could be all the way up, way up high in the emergent layer that are so high up that we haven't even been able to get up there. So we just don't know where these animals that haven't been discovered, where they live. There's so many places to hide in a rainforest. So your activity today is you have in your packet this really great information sheet, and then on the back it lists all sorts of types of animals that live in each of those layers of the rainforest. Then you have this like mini poster, and it has each layer listed, and it gives a little spot where you're going to tell me, or tell Miss Kimberly if you want to put it on Facebook or whatever, which layer your animal, because you also have in your pack a little animal, and everybody's animal is going to be a little bit different. Hopefully you didn't get two of the same animals at your house. I tried really hard to make sure that didn't happen. But so you can kind of look through your list of animals and then match it with your layers, and you're going to see which layer your animal lives in. So I have a couple of animals here. Maybe you can help me decide which layer they would live in. So we were just talking about the really large mammals. So this is a jaguar. So which layer do you think this one would live in? I think this would live in the forest floor layer. So the big jaguars are big wild cats. So tigers and jaguars, they all live in the forest floor layer. Okay. So I have another animal here. It's the one that Miss Kimberly's dressed up like today. It is the sloth. Which layer do you think this one belongs to? I don't know. This one's a little bit harder, because you would almost think that they would belong in the understory layer, because there's lots of branches and things. But actually, sloths live in the canopy layer. So they live in the second layer of the rainforest. So they're kind of in the middle. I bet you they might go down to this layer. So they probably go back and forth, but for the most part, you're gonna find your sloths in the canopy layer. So it'd be just kind of fun for you to read about the different layers of the rainforest and see where your animal belongs. And I'm really excited to see if you want to share with us which layer you think your animal belongs in. And that is all I have for you today. And we're going to bring on Miss Kimberly, also known as Miss Sloth, and she'll show you our food for today. Thanks, everybody.
Hello, everyone. So speaking of sloths, if you didn't know, there is a sloth, or maybe two, at the Denver Zoo. Miss Corinne just confirmed there are two. And they used to be in the birdhouse, and now they've moved them into the reptiles. And when I went, I did not see the sloths, and I was really disappointed. I thought, well, maybe they haven't opened it yet. But you know what? I didn't look up. And that was the problem, right, Miss Suzanne? Because they're in the canopy. And Miss Corinne went to the zoo, and she saw them because she looked up. So if you go to the zoo and you go to the reptile house, make sure that you look up and see if you can see those sloths up in the canopy of the zoo's rainforest. So, all right, so we are going to do our snack, and we are going to make a snake. So All right, so in your pack, you got some little licorice bits, you got a cheese stick, and some tomatoes. So we are going to start with our cheese stick. Let's see if Miss Kimberly can open a cheese stick on air, because she did not think to open it beforehand. All right, success. And I'm going to, because I have four tomatoes, I'm going to cut my cheese stick into five pieces. Then I'm going to take my tomatoes, and you can really do whatever pattern you want. I'm going to do kind of an alternating pattern here with my tomatoes and my cheese. And snakes, they aren't in a straight line, are they? So we're going to put him a little bit curvy. So then I have the most part of my snake, but then he needs eyes and he needs a tongue. Now, I think I forgot to put instructions in about half of the kits, so if you did not get instructions, I apologize. If you did get instructions, your snake looks a little bit different because they use cheese for his tongue. But I decided to use licorice. So I'm going to use that for his eyes. So my snake has big red eyes. And then I'm going to take another piece of licorice. So I just cut it into pieces and give him a little bit of a tongue. So then you have a yummy snake that you can eat. All right, that's what we have for you guys today. Just so you know what's coming up, tonight at 6:30, we have our third kids stage. And we have Ann Lincoln coming to do magic. Music is next week. So Ann Lincoln is coming to do magic. And if any of you came to the foam party last week, it's the same person who did the foam, and she is a whole lot of fun, and I think you'll really enjoy it. So that's at 6:30, no registration, just come, bring a blanket, bring a snack, and just enjoy with us. On Thursday, we are doing summer crafts. We have closed registration on that, but there are a couple of slots open at 3. If you would like to come and do that, just text me, call me, email me, and we'll slide you into one of those slots. And then the registration that is open is for next week, where we'll do our marine take and make. So those are ready to be picked up starting tomorrow. And then the following Thursday, we're going to do animal science. And we've got some fun things planned there. And maybe some crazy scientists will show up. So we'll see how that goes. So, all right, everybody, that's what we got going on. So we're going to go out with just a little more jungle music.